Do you think, specifically when it comes to film and television, there perhaps is a need for some form of grassroots reassessment about the structure of the industry and how people are remunerated for their work within it?
Absolutely. Sorry to interrupt you. And it's not just in this profession, it's in every profession, but it's been highlighted. First with the writers, why shouldn't they get a cut when something's successful? And I've always said, when I've worked on stuff where you've got your crew, your lighting, your sound people, if they're involved with a show that's doing well or that goes on to sell around the world, why shouldn't they get a cut? and then that goes again with companies, dividends, shareholders. Who the fuck are the shareholders? Who are the people doing the jobs, making that company work? There needs to be a redress of that. We don't need digital currency. We don't need the handouts. We need fairer pay reflected in the working people. And if that's not going to happen, then we need a revolution. And I'm going to be there. A couple of things, a really interesting project that Michael Sheen's directed, that Matthew Graham's written about a Welsh family who rise up against the system. And the army are brought in, and a new strain of COVID is used as an excuse to confine the Welsh in their country, and they manage to escape. And it's again a reflection of modern our times that we're living in. And little pockets around the country start asking, "What is a country? What is a government? It's not working for us. Let's stand up and fight." And then a little show called D.I. Ray up in Birmingham, Jed Mercurio producing. Parminder Nagra, I'm in that as well, so that's quite exciting. But yeah, let's all stand up and fight, man. Come on, because this is shit.